हेलो एवरीवन, आई असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर प्रगति शेटे फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ माइक्रोबायोलॉजी, के जे सोमैया कॉलेज. इन दिस ऑनलाइन लेक्चर वी विल स्टडी द लास्ट टू मेथड्स और द लास्ट वन मेथड फॉर द प्लांट डिसीज कंट्रोल. ओके, सो इन द लास्ट ऑनलाइन लेक्चर्स वी हैड स्टडीड द मेथड कॉल्ड एज द माइकोवायरसेस, यूज ऑफ द माइकोवायरसेस इन द प्लांट डिसीज कंट्रोल. Right, so now in this one we will study the how we can use the viral proteins in order to protect the plant from the viral infections. Right, so now as we know, starting with this lecture we will first take a short brief on the viruses, the plant viruses or the general viral structure. Okay, now as we know, viruses having the structure of the virus, okay, common structure will contain a genome, right? Then a genome with some enzymes such as the reverse transcriptase or RNA dependent RNA transcriptase. So this type of the enzyme, it will contain nucleases, okay? After the genome, whether it can be RNA or the DNA, then the virus will contain the nucleocapsid, right, the protein coat which will protect this genome of the virus, right? Then after that, every virus will then having a, most of the viruses are having the outer layer, okay, we called it as the envelope, okay, and the viruses which are having this envelope in their structure, we called it as the enveloped viruses, right? And the virus who lacks this envelope, we call them as the non-enveloped virus, right? So I hope everyone is aware of this basic viral structure, then we can proceed further. Okay, now on its lipid envelope or its genome, the virus contains some proteins, right? We can call it as the core proteins which are present in the core of the genome of the virus, or we can call it as the envelope proteins, right? Then the capsid proteins. So such proteins plays a very important role, okay, in the viral infection of the plants. So what we are doing, we are making the plant resistant with incorporation of this viral proteins that are present in the viruses, okay? Then what will happen, this viral proteins will kill the attacking virus. That means we are using one virus particles to kill another virus, okay? So this is the phenomena, this is the idea, basic logic principle behind this technique, okay? Now we will proceed with this part, okay? Now the first viral protein, or we can say the first viral infection in the plant, has been discovered for the tobacco mosaic virus and the tobacco mosaic plant, okay, and it was discovered by the Dimitri and the Martunis plants, okay. Then the first plant virus is the tobacco mosaic virus, TMV. It is a very well known studied virus of the plants, okay. Now you can see this picture is infected, the leaf is showing in this picture is got infected with that virus, and that is why that patches are present on that leaf. We will see later slides what are the symptoms, so in that you will get clear idea about the symptoms. All right, then after this we will see some of the, first, what are the plant viral diseases, okay, and their examples. Now the viral proteins mediated plant resistance, in that one we are now studying the plant viral diseases which are most common among the nature, okay. Then first one, the crop portion, you can see in the column of the crop, first one is the tomato plant, okay. Now in the tomato, the major virus diseases that are most probably caused in the tomatoes are the tomato leaf curl virus, okay, TCLV. You can see in this picture, in this picture you can see the leaf curling has been happened, and that is due to this viral infection, ओके, देन इंसिडेंस रेंज ऑफ दिस वायरस इज 40-70%, ओके, एंड यील्ड लॉस, दैट मीन्स इट विल कॉज डैमेज टू द एग्रीकल्चरल यील्ड, ओके, एट 40-50 degrees Celsius, राइट, एंड विच इज़ अ वेरी इफिशियंट अमाउंट टू कॉज द इकोनॉमिकल लॉस, ओके, ऑफ दिस क्रॉप, राइट. देन द सेकेंड वन इज द पपाया. सो इन द पपाया विच वायरल डिसीज इज मोस्ट कॉमन और विच वायरस इज मोस्ट इंसिडेंट इज द PRSV वायरस, दैट इज द पपाया रिंग स्पॉट वायरस टाइप पी, ओके, PRSV P. सो इट इज 80% इंसिडेंट प्रिविलेंस रेंज एंड द यील्ड लॉस इज 100%. Right, that means if once the papaya fruit is got infected due to this virus, then it will definitely cause the damage. Okay, so you can see in that fruit, the papaya picture, there are the rings, there are the spots. Okay, so that spots are due to this viral infection called as the PRSVP virus. Okay, now the third one, as we just saw in the earlier slide, that is the tobacco. The virus responsible is the tobacco mosaic virus. Prevalence range is 60% and yield loss is 80%. Okay. See, these viral infections are very much contagious and they spread very easily and they cause a very damage to whole agricultural field and the farm and then the products, okay, the crops. So it will also cause the economical loss also, right? And therefore, we are developing or we are now using this way. Okay, this is a very effective way that to produce the plant with this resistant plants with the incorporation of the viral proteins. Okay, now the next examples we have. The crop name is the cucurbit. Okay, the viruses that can infect these crops are the CMV virus, ZYMV virus. Okay, so such viruses are present in this type of the crops. Then in the banana, the bunchy top virus is present. Okay, both the prevalence and the yield loss are 100% in the both category, in the both of the example, that is in the cucurbit and the banana. Then third one, that is in the beans. Okay, in the bean, the bean common mosaic virus is a present. Prevalence rate is 60-70%. That means prevalence or incident rate is what? That means this much percent of the crops can get infected, or the virus ability to cause the 60-70% crops damage. Okay, that is its incidence rate. Then the yield loss is the 80-90%. Okay, so we now saw various types of these plant viral plant diseases. Okay, and which are the viruses that are most responsible for causing this viral infection in the plants, right? Now I hope you will get an idea basically that this type of the virus are present in the plants, right? These are unlike from the human viruses. These are little bit different. Okay, now the types of the plant viral genome we will study. Okay, so the most commonly they are genome containing double stranded DNA, single stranded DNA, and the single stranded negative sense RNAs are rare. The first three categories genome are rare. What is the common? Single stranded positive sense RNA is most commonly present genome type in this plant viruses. Okay, so what is the commonly present viral particle genome will contain? Single stranded positively sense RNAs, right? Now after that, the family can contain the Gemini Viridae, okay, then the Col Imoviridae. So such families can be present in this type of the viral infections. Okay, so here are the structures that you can see. See, double-stranded RNA, then the single-stranded RNA, single-stranded RNA positively sends and the negatively sends, okay? They have described, they have distributed the each group, and among that group, they have mentioned some of the examples. Alright? So, these are the basic genome of the plant viruses. And in that, the single-stranded positively sense RNA is the most common type of the virus. Okay? Now, after this, we will study how the transmission is occurring between this plant and the viruses. Okay? So, this we are studying because then after that, when we study the plant viral proteins, so at that time, these points or this mechanism will help to relate with that content. Alright, then now we will study the plant virus transmission, okay, the process in between. Then, as we know, the virus is most probably enter via any injured region, okay, so they are entering through the healable wounds. Okay, wound or anything is present in the plant, then they can enter there very well. Okay, then the insect vectors are most important means of the natural spread. Okay, now after this, the type of transmission or the vector relationship determine the epidemiology. Right, so certain parameters such as the vector transmission, which types of the vectors or which types of the host, okay, the relationship between the vector and the host, these points will help us to determine its epidemiology. Okay, then after that, the seed transmission is also can happen. Virus can spread via the seeds, okay, through the seedling process. Then the mechanical transmission include the field tools, farm tools, okay, then drug inoculation, greenhouse, then cutting tools. These are the instruments. See, in cases of the human viral infections, how the human will get the hospitality infections or the nosocomial infections through the any needles or through any equipments. So in these cases, in the viral infections, what are happening? The mechanical transmission via then the through the greenhouses, okay, through the cutting tools, through the farm tools, field tools, okay, then certain instruments, the contaminated instruments. So by that, it can very well spread. Okay, then after that, these are the transmission routes, we can say, okay, which are the routes where the viruses can reach to their host, that is to the plant. Okay, now we will see the life cycle of the virus inside the plant. Okay, now as we know, the virus life cycle will include the attachment, penetration, then the replication, right? Penetration, then replication, then after replication, then it will produce this capsid and proteins. Okay, then what it will do, it will assemble and then it will release. And then it will again multiply from that each release. Then each viral new virus body will again continue to divide. And this is how the viral yield will spread. Alright. Now first in the attachment. Now attachment require the envelope proteins. Now these points are very important. Okay. Now the attachment of the virus will require the viral proteins, right? As we know, if the virus has to attach to the host site of attachment, then what it will do, it will use its viral proteins for the attachment, and that protein will mediate the route for the entry of the virus through the host cell or the host membrane, we can say. राइट. देयरफॉर दिस रिक्वायर स्पेशलाइज्ड एनवेलप प्रोटीन्स. दिस प्रोटीन मेक द वायरस स्पेसिफिक फॉर द डिफरेंट सेल्स. सो दिस प्रोटीन्स आर बेसिकली एंटीजन्स ऑफ द वायरस एंड एज वी नो एंटीजन्स आर वेरी स्पेसिफिक okay for its binding sites. So therefore it is making it specific for different types of the cells, different binding receptor sites. All right, once it got attached with the help of its protein, the viral protein, then what it will do, it will now penetrate, right? It will penetrate inside the host cell. Now the viral particle will enter the host to the enter the cell, and the viral envelope fuses with the cell membrane. Okay, listen carefully. Viral envelope will now fuse, okay, with the membrane of the host cell. Okay, you can see in that picture also, the first one is the attachment, right? The virus is getting attached. After that, the penetration, then the virus is getting penetrating. So in the box just next to the diagram, you see the penetration. So that portion you can see the viral particle is getting inside, right, through the membrane, and therefore the viral envelope fuses with the cell membrane. The capsid and the genetic material then enter into the nucleus of the cell, host cell. Right, now you can see the protein is getting breakdown of the virus, and then the genomic material of the virus is getting entered into the nucleus. Okay, now after that, what will it will do? Now the genome role is what? To replicate, right? And therefore then it will replicate. Replication process will then takes place, right? Then in the replication, what virus will do? Virus will uses the host machinery, okay, nutrients or the enzymes, to make many copies of themselves, copies of the viruses, right? Now this is the replication. So first in this slide we studied the attachment require viral proteins. You can see in this diagram here, you can see here is the viral structure, and on the viral you can see there are the proteins in the envelope, right? Then that envelope and the green color one is the host membrane. So now the proteins, you can see producing the signals, okay, or we can say the markers. So by that they are, what it will do, it will break that membrane, and then it will help the virus particle to enter into that host membrane. All right, host cell, once it got entered with the help of the viral antigens, viral proteins, then it will penetrate, right? For the penetration, what it will do? It will conjugate or it will fuse with the host cell membrane. Viral proteins or the viral envelope then will fuses with the cell membrane, and thereby it will remove its own envelope, okay? And it will only allow the genome of it to release and to go inside the nucleus. Once the genome is getting inside the body of the host cell, then it will replication. It will do the replication of itself with the help of the host machinery. All right. After the replication, the new virus particles are produced. Right. Then what it will do, the genome of the virus then will translate proteins, and then after it will do translation, right, then it will do the transcription. Sorry, the viruses uses the host translation machinery. Then what will happen, the virus copies will be produced, okay? After that, it will now produce the new capsid, okay? It will use the protein translation process, okay? So that it will produce proteins, and that protein, with the help of that produced proteins, it will produce its own capsid. And as we know, capsid is made up of proteins, ओके देन एनवेलप प्रोटीन मूव टू द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन ओके एंड दिस मूवमेंट इज अगेन विद द हेल्प ऑफ द होस्ट प्रोटीन सिक्रीशन बिकॉज इन द होस्ट सेल इट्सेल्फ द प्रोटीन्स आर गेटिंग मूव्ड नेचुरल प्रोटीन्स आर गेटिंग मूव्ड टू द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन एंड देयरफॉर अलोंग विद दैट प्रोटीन द वायरल प्रोटीन विल ऑल्सो मूव टू द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन देन आफ्टर दे मूव टू द प्लाज्मा देन द असेंबली ऑफ द न्यू प्रोटीन न्यू वायरल पार्टिकल्स जेनेटिक मटेरियल इज पैकेज्ड इनटू द न्यू कैप्सिड्स राइट दैट वी कॉल्ड एज द असेंबली they will come together now we have the protein capsids and then the newly genome okay transcribed genome then the genome is then packed with the is getting packed with the new capsids after the assembly is done after the new virus particle is completely made then what will happen then that will release from the host okay the host cell right then the capsid moves to the cell membrane get wrapped in their envelope proteins and move on to the infecting neighboring cell. So this process is present in the one cell of the host, in the one nucleus. Okay. Similarly, now this process is present in one of the cell. Now the process has been completed. Newly produced viral particles has been released. Newly virus particles are now entered into the other cells of the host. And in similar way, they will produce such large quantities of their cells. Right? And that is why now they will cause infection. Now their yield will be more in the host than the original host particles. And that is why now they will produce the toxins which will damage the host. Okay, that is the plant in this case. This is the viral replication process inside the plant host cells. Right? Now we will study the movement of the pathogen from the cell to cell. Okay, so this is also very interesting. Next point, okay. So in that, the viruses will move through the plant in the same direction when following a successful penetration. Now in this case, we are having the movement proteins that are those are responsible for movement of the particles. What are doing the movement proteins? How it will enhance the movement of the particle? By it will enlarge the pore sides of the plasmodesmata and activate the transportation of the pathogen, right? Now, as we know, if the cell membrane size of the, or we can say the pores are introduced into the membrane, then what it will do? It will allow the particles to pass through it. Right, and therefore the similar mechanism is used by this movement particle. They are enlarging the pore size. Okay, they are enlarging the pore size of the plasmodesmata. Okay, you can see in the picture. This is the plasmodesmata. So they are enlarging the size of the plasmodesmata in such a way. They are now moving. Movement proteins will transfer. Alright. Now, thereby allow the local and the systemic spread of pathogen in the plants. And therefore, they can infect the plant cells and the plant body. Okay. Now, and therefore, the entry point. From the entry point, the pathogen will move from the cell to cell contact via the plasmodesmata. Okay, because plasmodesmata is the membrane who is responsible for attachment of two cells. The between is present is the plasmodesmata, and therefore we are calling that the entry point. Okay, first the pathogen will move to the another cell via the plasmodesmata. Okay. Now as a pathogen, okay, now the pathogen as it travel
it will also reproduce, right? Then some of the viruses or some of the pathogen can exit the infected plant by the stomata and infect the nearby plants. So this is the one important mechanism how the virus will infect the other plants. Okay, so we say that if one plant is getting very damaged, then we better remove that plant from that particular area. Why? Because it will cause the other plants infected too. And this phenomena or this process is how it is happening, because then the infected viral particles or the replicated viral particle can get exit from that original host, original plant, and that can enter into the neighboring plant. And this is how they will increase their infection range, increase their host range. Okay. Then if the pathogen gets to the bundle sheath, okay, of the plant, it will rapidly transport it through the plant by the xylem and the phloem. Okay, so the movement is also getting enhanced of the virus movement through the bundle sheath with the help of the xylem and the phloem. Okay, these are the movements of the pathogen from the one cell to the another cell. Okay, in this we are studying the newly replicated viruses, how they will move from one cell to the another via the plasmodesmata. They will increase the pore size of the plasmodesmata, thereby the movement proteins can move from one cell to the another cell. Okay, and in this process the newly produced viral particles can also get exit from that original host and can infect the neighboring plants. Okay, neighboring plants. Now after that, the pathogen movement is also enhanced with the help of the bundle sheath. If they got attached onto the bundle sheath, then they can rapidly transport it to the other cells with the help of the xylem and the phloem. Okay, now these are the symptoms. Okay, how the plants, infected viral diseases plants, will look like. Now first we saw this ring spots on the papaya plant also in the previous tables, right? So this is the first symptom, or we can say the indications of the viral infections. The ring spots, then the deformities. Okay, you can see the whole structure is getting very damaged. Then third one is the phylloly. Okay, phylogy. That also the leaves, the shapes are getting damaged. Then the wilt. This is the example of the wilt. And then the mosaic. Okay. So these are the some of the indications or symptoms of the viral infections in the plants. Okay. Now we will come to this point, that is the uses of this viral proteins in protection of the plants against this viral pathogens, right? Now the plant responses to the viruses. Okay, in that, now as a human we know that if any pathogen is getting enter inside our body, then our body will definitely produce some kind of the immune response or some types of the antibodies to defense against that pathogen. Okay, so this is the human immunity. Similar to the humans, the plant will also respond in some way, right? So now we will see that how the plants are getting defense by their own, okay, against this plant viral infections. Now we will see the plant responses to the virus. Okay, so first one, that is the antiviral immune response. Okay, so in this, the immune cells will be there, okay. So the local necrotic lesions were a sign of a plant viral infection, okay, rapidly opened up to the prospectus to determine
वायरस टाइटर, आइसोलेट वायरसेस और डिसेक्ट एंटीवायरल डिफेंसेस एंड टू क्वांटिफाई द वायरस पार्टिकल्स प्रेजेंट इन दैट प्लांट. ओके, सो बाय दैट लीजन्स वी कैन डिटरमाइन द इम्यूनिटी अगेंस्ट दैट वायरस. द नेक्रोटिक लीजन्स, ओके, लोकल लीजन्स. Then the second is the R gene mediated responses to the virus infection. What is the R gene? Recognition of the specific pathogen effect us. Okay, either can be through the binding directly or by recognizing them. Okay, or the recognition of the host, recognition of the effectors, alteration of a host protein. So by that way also we can determine the response of the plant to this viral infection. Okay, now this virulence factors drove co-evolution of the plant resistant genes to combat the pathogen antivirulent genes. So basically these points are saying that the parts or the portion of the plants which we can use to determine the immune response or the defense response against this plant diseases, plant viruses, right? Such as the necrotic lesions or the to recognized by recognizing the specific pathogen effectors, and then we can study the binding of that effector as direct or by recognition of the effector's alteration, okay, or we can determine the altered protein in the plant due to that virus. Okay, so in that way we can determine this plant responses. Then the hypersensitive and necrotic resistant response to the virus infection. Now HR response, that is the hypersensitive response, is initiated by antiviral protein interaction that will result into the change in the hormonal levels of the plants. As we know, the plant will contain many hormones required for its growth, right? So that will get affected due to this viral infection, such as the salicylic acid, jasmonic acid, nitric oxide, accumulation of ROS. Okay, these are some of the example. These are some of the things that can get affected due to this viral infection. Then after that, the systemic necrosis responses. Now the systemic necrosis was reported in the Nicotiana plant, which were inoculated with the TMV, tobacco mosaic viruses. Okay, so in that case the systemic response, necrotic response from the plant has been recorded. And the ubiquitin proteasome system. Now as we know, the ubiquitin enzyme or the ubiquitin ligase enzyme is the very major component, is very essential component which is in the protein degradation pathway. Okay, protein degradation or the immune signaling pathways. Okay, and this enzyme, the ubiquitin proteasome enzyme system or the ubiquitin proteasome system, has emerged as a prominent player in influencing the virus host interactions. Okay, so this system, the ubiquitin proteasome system, as it is responsible for what? Degradation of the protein. So it can result into the degradation of the viral proteins also. And if once the viral proteins are getting damaged, then the virals will not be effective, right? So this is also reported that this can also help the host to defense against such viral infections. Alright? Then after this, now this is about the viral protein responses, okay, from the plant.
the immune responses, we can say, of the plant for the viruses, plant viruses. All right. Now we will see how we develop the resistance in the plant using this viruses, plant virus. Now this is important part in this. Okay. Now you can see here. Now here is the list of the proteins, okay, viral protein mediated resistant types in the plant, in the host plant, which can get infected by the virus. Okay, so now first one is the pathogen derived resistant, and the second one is the non-pathogen protein mediated resistance. Okay, so in the in the first category, that is in the pathogen derived resistance, so it will be like the resistance which was developed or which is coming from the pathogen. So we are using pathogen molecules, okay, for producing resistance in our host plant. So that is called as the pathogen mediated resistance. So now in the protein mediated resistance, then the coat protein mediated resistance, replicase mediated resistant, movement protein mediated resistance, RNA mediated resistance, and the sRNAs that target the vRNAs for their degradation. These proteins we can use in the plant genome or in the plant virus, plant cells, so that they will develop the resistance against this type of the proteins. Now as we know, the mentioned, as now just now I read these names, this all proteins are present in the virus structure. If you remember, the very first we have discussed the structure of the virus, right? So in that we can say these proteins are present in the viruses, and therefore we can use these proteins to make the plant resistance against this viral infections. Okay, therefore they are called as the coat protein. Now why calling as the coat protein mediated resistance? Because we will incorporate this plant cells with the viral coat proteins, capsid proteins. That is why the coat protein mediated resistance. Now in case of the replicase mediated, and now we know the viral genome is contain the replicase enzyme. So we can take that enzyme and we can make the plant resistant using that enzyme, using that protein. Okay. Then movement protein. Now in just now in the earlier previous slides, we just studied about the movement proteins, right? That it will penetrate into the cell to cell via the plasmodes stomata, right? Then like that, these are the proteins that are already present in the viral structure, and we are taking that protein to make our plant resistance against this viral infections. Okay. Then the non-pathogen mediated resistance, in that the transcription regulators we can introduce into the plant, or we can introduce the DNA binding protein, then interferon like strategies we can inculminate into the plant. Okay, then translation factors, cofactors we can also incorporate into the host plant. This all proteins or this mediated resistance will help the plant to defense against that virus attack, right? And therefore we are making the plant resistant against that viral infection, viruses. Alright, then these are the types of the resistance we can produce using that virus proteins. Okay, after this, now the transgenics, that means the transgenic plants with the pathogen derived resistance. Okay, so now say the expression of the sequences derived from the plant virus in the transgenic plants can induce the protection against that disease, and the concept is called, that means the concept is called as, for this developing resistance, pathogen derived resistance. So as I just we discussed in the earlier slide, this will include this much points, okay? Coat protein, replicase protein, movement protein, satellite RNA, sRNAs, okay? Then the antisense RNA strategies. Antisense RNA strategies, we have discussed, we have studied this complete lecture on this antisense RNA method, right? You can refer that lecture, you can refer that video to get understand this method in detail, okay? Then after that, we will study the one example. If we introduce the coat protein into the plant, so what it will do? It will resistance against the coat proteins. Now we called it as the coat protein mediated resistance. If we are incorporating movement proteins, then what the plant, the what type of the resistance is there? Movement protein mediated resistance. Okay, if we are incorporating the satellite RNAs, then what type of the resistance? Satellite RNA mediated resistance, like that. Okay, now in this case we are having the coat protein mediated resistance. Now the use of the viral coat proteins as a transgene for developing the resistant plant is one of the most efficient, is one of the most spectacular successful method, okay, in the plant biotechnology. Numerous crops, that means the various types of the large number of the crops have been transformed with this coat protein, okay, and that have been shown also, reported also, to show the high level of the resistance against this viruses. Okay, for example, the scientist, the Powell Abel, reported the resistance against the tobacco mosaic virus in the transgenic tobacco which were expressing the tobacco mosaic virus coat protein gene. So like this, right? Now I hope you understood. Okay, so this is the one example of the coat proteins, okay, coat protein mediated resistance. For example, in the tobacco mosaic virus, we have obtained the coat proteins from this virus and then we have incorporated this into the plant cells. Now the plant is the coat protein resistant plant, and as we know, these proteins are very much essential in the penetration and in the growth, or we can say in the attachment, okay, to the host site. And now as the proteins are not getting attached, proteins are getting damaged of the virus, then the viral effectiveness will not be processed further, right? So this is basically phenomena, okay? So for example, in the TMV virus, we can make the TMV CP plants, coat protein mediated resistant plants, okay, with the help of the TMV CP gene. Okay, now the next, what are the hypothesis about the mechanism? Now the perfect mechanism base underlines this has been not very clear, but we can hypothesize some of the mechanisms, okay, of the coat proteins. Now for example, there can be the different types of the receptor, okay, or the uncoating sites within the cell that can be responsible for initiating the assembly of the viruses. Now as I mentioned, the proteins are responsible for its replication and its attachment. Similarly, the some kind of the receptor or the some kind of the uncoating will be responsible or will be needed for assembly of the new virus, new virions, okay. That will, what it will do, it will release the, you can see, that are responsible for initiating the disassembly of the virus. Okay, this is the original role of that coat proteins. Now the coat protein mediated resistance will block this site prior to the infection. Now what will happen? Now virus will not enter into the host cell, and then infection will not be developed, right? So therefore preventing virus to attach to the cells. Okay, so this is one hypothesis about the mechanism, that the some kind of the receptors or the uncoating site, okay, are responsible, that is the coat proteins in the virus are responsible for, or we can say the uncoating sites are responsible for initiating the disassembly of the virus. Okay, for virus to replicate, to infect, they should release the genome of that virus, okay, from that protein coat, right? This much I hope you know. Okay, just now we studied in the earlier slides, in the replication process of the virus, that first it will attach, then it will penetrate. Right, then in the second stage, in the penetration, what it will do, it will break that protein capsid, it will break that coat layer, and then the genome of the virus will enter. Okay, therefore this process is getting inhibited, the disassembly will not happen of the genome, and therefore the infection will not be happen. This is because of the coat proteins. The coat proteins will block the site which are responsible for the disassembly. Therefore this will prevent the virus to attach to the cell. Then second, the presence of the transgenic derived coat protein in the cytoplasm may tip the disassembly and assembly equilibrium, okay, of the entering virus, incoming virus, and therefore they can challenge the virus, or they can make the difficult, they make virus difficult to enter, to uncoat. Okay, that is why we are calling it as the coat protein. It will resist the process of the uncoating. Okay, the presence of transgenic derived coat proteins, this means the transgenic plants with the coat proteins, okay, that can tip the disassembly-assembly equilibrium of the virus. They will disturb this equilibrium, and due to this, again, the similarly, the uncoating will not be happened, and therefore the virus will not get infected. Okay, the plant will not get infected due to that virus. Okay, these are the mechanisms, most hypothesized mechanism in this way, the about the coat proteins. Okay, in this way the plants get resistant using this viral proteins. This is the very effective process. Okay, this has been used for the long back. Okay, now we can see some coat protein mediated resistant crops example. Now you can see here the cereals, maize, rice, wheat crops. Okay, so these are get infection against this MDMV, then RSV, this type of the viruses. Okay, then in the fruits, papaya, plum. Okay, in the papaya, which is the PRV virus, is causing the infection in the papaya, right? Just now we saw in these slides. And the coat protein transgenic plants has been reported successfully, that has shown the resistance.